Hello, children. I'm a British person. Are we sitting comfortably? Good. Would you like me to read you a story? You would? Then I'll begin.
Hello, everybody, and welcome to the making of Bat Sweeper. This game took me 3 days to make, altogether about 20 hours, although afterwards I did playtest it for 4 or 5 hours, making small, boring tweaks that I didn't think you'd want to see. So yeah, in the next couple of videos, I'll show you how I made the game. As you can see, I started off with the clouds. You're meant to start off with something like the movement or something boring like that when making a game. But I had an idea for the clouds and I just built it up from there. So here I am, programming it all in. I'm also adding in the level in front of it. No detail at the moment. And I decided to cheat here and copy and paste the movement engine I'd made before, which saved me a bit of time. But it's really boring and you wouldn't want to see it, so it's okay. Here I am drawing the main character. I didn't want him to be sexy or handsome or anything like that, and I think I succeeded with that. This is the main character. I wanted him to look horrible and, you know, act horrible, but he's a nice person really. It took a while to blend into this game because there were a couple of bugs, and I also had to change the movement slightly because I didn't want him to be able to hang on to ledges. Since the beginning of this project, I wanted to add in a special sort of movement system. This is the suction power I'm adding in now. Anyway, I should start doing the Hoover soon. And the idea is he uses a Hoover to suck enemies into it, and also to blow himself across the level. So here I am drawing it all in. And I'm programming what happens if you aim in a certain direction and fire at the moment. Just playtesting it, should take a while to do. This game was for a competition, and it had to be a happy Halloween game, and I'm not good with happy things. My games always end up really twisted and horrible and sick, but with this game I think I did quite a good job. You don't really kill anyone, only one person dies, and that was just as a joke at the end of the project. You'll see who it is. I found a new way of drawing stuff with this project. I drew it twice the size it should have been, and then resized it to half the size, and it makes it nice and blurry. You can see me playing another game then, that's just Aiden's new game, someone I know on MSN. I'm quite happy with the way this texture turned out. It's colourful, and it fits the game quite well. Most of my games are quite bland and samey in colour, so this game's different. It's nice and colourful. Adding in the grass here. It's nice just to break up the edges, otherwise it's all sort of clinical and harsh. And I've already got a playable game. And here I'm just setting up the sound so it creates a random suck sound every time you use the vacuum. In fact, I even videoed myself recording the sounds. Here's the video clip. Yes, I did enjoy doing it, and I was using Audacity to record it. I originally had different sounds for suck and blow, but it was so annoying I had to get rid of it. Here's an example. Anyway, back to the game making. I carried on adding all the side bits to the block. I made it so that when you shoot the grass it kind of ruffles about a bit. This bit of the game is a bit boring to make. I just sort of added special effects, tweak the movement and that sort of stuff. Really boring to watch, which is why this one's sped up so much. There's me recording the sound samples that you saw me doing earlier. A lot of playtesting in this stage. I'd say that game making is about 10% coding, 10% graphics design, and 80% playtesting. It changes as you go on. At the beginning it's mostly graphics and coding. But as it goes on, you start doing lots and lots of playtesting. Thankfully this bit's almost over now, I can start getting on with all the exciting bits. I made this song last Christmas. No one really liked it that much, but I have big plans for this song. I made it so that when you press both mouse buttons at the same time, it depletes your vacuum power and makes this green smoke come out of the end of your Hoover. But I replaced it later with a projectile that gets fired out because it gave it a use instead of just being a punishment if you press both buttons at the same time. Made it much better. And there you can see I just added in the narration bit. And here I add a very quick intro and main menu screen. I do this when I don't feel I'm making much progress because it makes it feel as if I've done a lot more work than I have. It's good when it gets to a boring stage of the game making. Here I start adding world objects and spikes because the sooner you get to a playable demo, the better the game is, because then you can playtest it more, you have something to work on. It's really motivating. If you just spend days and days working on the engine without getting to a playable level, it's really hard to carry on. So here's the spikes. I also added a game over screen. Don't know what I was doing there. Just improving the graphics a bit. And now I work on the tutorial bit, because I always seem to skip that bit when making games normally. I also added in all the dialogue. I didn't add in the voices until later though. All of the songs you've heard so far are in the game. This one I made earlier this year. I included it in another game I made, Scrumpy Ninja and the Case of the Bad Eggs. I didn't ever count it as one of my proper songs that I made, because I never finished it. It sounded a bit messy to me. But yeah, it's alright for computer games, I guess. And for those of you interested in knowing how this thing works, at the beginning of the level, I set the value to zero, and then freeze the player until you press the mouse button. When you press the mouse button, it plays another load of text, sets its value to one. When its value is one and you press the mouse button, it lets him move until you get to another bit of the game. And it carries on that way. And I set up a load of triggers along the way, just areas in the level, that when he walks into it, it freezes him and shows another load of text, and that's how I did the tutorial. I also drew in some animations for the character, didn't include them until later, but you know, if you stand still for long enough, he'll, well, do loads of weird stuff. I think I added in the voice clips here. I've got a video clip of me doing that. I'll just show it to you.
Oh no. Oh no. Oh no. Oh no. Oh no. Oh no. Oh no, I can't sweep up all this rubbish. Oh no, I'm gonna sweep up all this rubbish.
Rubbish.
Oh no, I'm gonna sweep up all this rubbish.
Rubbish.
Oh no, I'm gonna sweep up all this rubbish. Oh no, I'm gonna sweep up all this rubbish. Oh no, I'm gonna sweep up all this rubbish.
Oh, my life is so boring and all, because I have to sweep up all this rubbish.
That's about it, really. I can experiment with this, then when I'm ready, I can go through the door.
That's about it, really. I can experiment with this, then when I'm ready, I can go through the door.
And that concludes part one of The Making of Batsweeper. If you're interested in seeing what it was like at the end of day one, you can download it. It's in the description of this video. And if you don't want to play it, then I can't force you to.